So let's talk about the refresher courses dilemma and the new circular number 19 of 21 and much, much more. So this topic is only relevant for those who have Indian COC or who has done any STCW course in India. This particular video is aimed to remove all kinds of confusion as to what refresher courses to be done or not to be done. Let's begin with the video. So we will first discuss what is written in STCW code with respect to refresher courses. We will see how the DG circular is framed by taking the reference from the STCW code. We will see in depth what is written in the circular NT/Engineering Circular number 2 of 2015. It is the chapter 6 which deals with this STCW course and the refreshers associated with this. And over here, along with the section A6.1, that is your basic familiarization training course, you will be able to see the basic training one has to undergo is your PHT, fire prevention and firefighting, that is your basic firefighting, EFA and PSSR. Paragraph 3 deals that the courses given in paragraph 2, the whole thing has to be repeated every 5 years. That is on top, but only some topics, because some topics will be taken care as onboard training and some topics you have to do it in the training institutes. Same thing is for PSCRB as well, A6 chapter 2. So you can see over here the competency mentioned in A6 chapter 2-1. You have to repeat this particular course in every 5 years. Some of the competencies you have to carry out in the training institutes and some of them will be considered as onboard training. It is exactly same for advanced firefighting as well, and paragraph 5 states that you have to do this competencies every 5 years. Some of them will be considered onboard training and some of them you have to do with the institutes. So now let's head on to the DG circular on this particular STCW 2010. So as you can see in this circular, it is clearly mentioned in paragraph 2 that all the refresher courses PhD, FPFF, PSCRB and AFF has to be done, because the STCW regulations over here are completely different. At the bottom in the next paragraph, paragraph number 4, it is also mentioned that if it is being done, demonstrated as onboard training, then we will not be including that competency in the course. And everyone knows that it has to be done once in every 5 years. If you scroll down quickly at the bottom, you can see that the course objective and the course content, everything is mentioned in Annex 1 and Annex 2 of this circular. So this is the Annex 1, and it clearly mentions the topics, the competencies as listed in the STCW code. What all things we are supposed to be doing in the training institutes. And the next one is the Annex 2, that is the course outline, that how much amount of time will be given for completing that kind of competencies for each individual courses, that is the basic as well as the advanced, and none of the competencies except one are being repeated. So we will go to the next circular, Anti-Engineering Circular number 2 of 2015, which was supposed to be removing certain amount of confusion, creating hardships to the confusion of the seafarers, etc. So they have made one chart, Annexure 1, which we will see in this particular course. Regarding the bullet points in paragraph number 2, if the relevant certificate is more than 5 years old, your PhD, FPFF, advanced firefighting, PSCRB, etc. are more than 5 years old, then you are supposed to do your refresher courses. However, seafarers holding advanced safety training certificate should undertake refresher training covering the elements of both the basic and advanced safety courses as indicated in Annexure 1 every 5 years. That means even if I have AFF refresher or AFF certificate as well,
I must have FPFF certificate. Even if I have PSCRB, I should have PHPRF as well. Since to remove the simplify or simplification, they have made a combined training course, which we all know that with when you do your AFF refresher, the training modules for FPFF, similarly PSCRB, the training modules of PhD courses were already added, and hence we were all getting the combined course certificate, and the format of that combined course certificate is shown in the annexure 3. It is further clarified that MFA, medical care, etc., MLC, familiarization certificates are doesn't come under the purview of STCW. However, you require it under the MLC 2006, right? So you are supposed to do all those kind of refresher. Now coming back to this particular annexure, what was the most confusing part over here is that the people were not reading the annexure as whole. For example, the second mate or equivalent MEO class 4, which I will be coming back. So second mate, even if it is foreign going or NCV, when he was checking the certificates, he was just seeing on the top that do I require a PhD refresher, then the answer was no, and do I require a PSCRB refresher, the answer was yes. So the confusion was that I have PSCRB refresher and that's it, and similarly should I have FPFF refresher over here, the answer is no, but the advanced firefighting, yes. Okay, so the confusion was that if I have PSCRB refresher and AFF refresher, I don't require FPFF refresher, I don't require the basic PhD refresher as well. But people failed to see that in column number 10, it was not PSCRB refresher, but it was PSP and PSCRB. Okay. So you are doing PSCRB plus PhD refresher combined training course only, and since you have already taken care of your PhD refresher requirements, those modules, those competencies, hence it doesn't make sense for you to do again a PhD refresher as a standalone, because everything has been taken care in this column number 10, and similarly for your annex 1 column number 12. Over here, your advanced firefighting and basic firefighting combined course has been taken care. So no need to do a separate basic firefighting because those modules have been taken care over here. So similarly, each ranks have been told to do so, that just do combined, 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 just do combined. It is only those ratings like engine ratings which are don't require the competency of a PSCRB or advanced firefighting, and for those only you require the basic refresher competencies only. The trainees also, you don't require to do these things because you don't require PSCRB and advanced firefighting, and hence all the certificates were of combined in nature. Furthermore, if you can see, I have clearly marked that the red color ones are the topics which are to be covered in the institutes, and you can see that the competencies are completely different. The red ones being shown as an individual level, and the blue color ones are mostly in order to train others as well as to have that knowledge, mostly on survival craft. But that doesn't mean that you should stay away from the competency of wearing a life jacket or don and use an immersion suit, which is not a competency in PSCRB, but it is a competency in PhD. So you have to do your PhD refresher for satisfying this particular red color competencies, and PSCRB refresher will take care of the remaining competencies over here which are marked in the blue. Similarly, the FPFF refresher will take the competencies marked in the red color, while as advanced firefighting refresher will take the care of your competencies every 5 years, which is marked in the blue. And clearly you can see that the competencies, the topics, the subjects which are these refresher courses cover are completely different, and hence both of them has to be done. That means your FPFF refresher, advanced firefighting refresher, your PhD refresher and PSCRB refresher, all the courses have to be done.
So why this confusion is that some mariners are still sailing without basic refresher.
It is a wrong notion that if I do advanced refresher, I don't require a basic refresher. Competencies are completely different. Combined courses were cancelled, but it doesn't affect anyone because I don't want to do basic refresher. Again, wrong idea or notion. And the companies are not scrutinizing the documentations properly, maybe. So why they are not doing it, I have no idea. So in order to reduce the confusion, DGCPing has just recently released one circular dated 17 June, that is the DG circular number 19 of 2021, in which they got the whole issue which started with 2011 was discussed. It is clearly mentioned over here that we have to do all the four basic PST, FPFF and advanced PSC, RB and AFF refresher every 5 years. It has been discussed in detail that in order to remove the confusion, circular number 2 of 2015 was also mentioned over here, as which we have discussed it before. The DGS order number 40 was introduced for doing the 3-tier courses, but it introduced the combined refresher courses. But in order to remove the whole confusion, what they have done is that they have withdrawn this combined refresher courses and added the competencies of refresher course of PST in PSCRB, and the competencies for your FPFF has been added in AFF. So the everything, the course content, the e-learning, the exit exam, everything is now added in 6212, and everything is added in AFF course ID refresher itself. So all the officers and DEC, able seafarers AB, only need to do refresher training in PSCRB and refresher training in AFF, and other ratings other than the DEC AB needs to do the refresher training for the basic courses, that is your PhD and FAFF only. This circular will come into force from 5th July 2021. Please do like, share and subscribe. Stay safe, stay secure. Thank you very much.